shit, I pull over and I start praying for people. I don't care who they are. I'm like, yo, you want to pray? They were like, sure, I take one. That's where I am, man. I pull over and pray for people, man.
Right.
I pull over, man. It's real, man.
Wow. Well, we can start. I don't want to prolong it. But we're going to all chime in together and go in. And like I said before, we need to do this at least once a month for now, but we need to do it quite often. It's great to hear a sermon. It's great to hear scripture. We know that scripture gives life, it gives hope. Some understanding and some don't understand. But in right now, we're dealing with so many issues. Issues of death, issues of sicknesses, issues of just no hope, loss of hope, loss of trust. We have saints that's losing jobs, saints that lost faith because of a sickness they've been praying to be healed from for years. And tonight I'm not going to go scriptural. We're just going to pray as a whole, as a body. So I will ask for everyone to come in and just pray. I would ask for you to call in as well, those that can. So I'm going to start. Father, we come before you right now, Lord God. We just lift you up because you are the great you are, which is the great I am that you said you are in the great book. We just thank you now, Lord God, that every book out there that was written, Lord God, every book that was published, Lord God, it was yet published by man. But yet, Lord God, your spirit is free and it's liberty where you are. We thank you now, Lord, that you will continue to use us for your glory so we can be earthly beings and be worth something in this earth. We thank you now, Father, that all that's been going through things this week, today, this year, Lord God, already, Lord God. You said in January, Lord God, things need to be ironed out. By the end of January, if things are not ironed out, if your head and your mind is not steadfast and set on the things that the Lord has called them to be on, this again is a warning. It's going to be the worst year you ever had. Receive it if you want to and don't if you don't. But it is a prophetic word. Now, we need to continue to stay in the face of God. We need to continue to lift up everything that's not right. He said every crooked thing will become straight. Everything that's not right in your life, seek him out. Seek him first, the kingdom of God, and all his righteousness, and everything shall be added unto you. Everything shall be ironed out unto you. Lord, we just thank you right now, Lord God. We lift ourselves up to you, Lord God, with travail, Lord God, not just with our mouth, but with our heart, with our minds, with our soul, Lord God. We just ask that you would diminish us, Lord God. We decrease as you increase right now. We just thank you right now, Father, that everyone, Lord God, that's on this call, Lord God, that will pray tonight, that they will see a breakthrough, they will feel, Lord God, you, Lord God, in a mightier way than ever before. We come against sickness right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We come against lack in the name of Jesus Christ. Those that have lost their jobs, those that is going through a storm right now, that don't know where tomorrow is going to bring them, what's going to happen tomorrow, what's going to happen the rest of the year. Father, we thank you, Lord God, in your word, Lord God, the word that you have given me to Rhema, you said this month, Lord God, it will be the beginning, Lord God, of a great year if we can follow and listen to you. Lord, I thank you now that it's you, Lord God, that we live, it's you that we see, it's you that we can hear, Lord God. And Lord God, I say now to your people, Lord God, hear what the Spirit is saying, not your emotion. Hear what God is speaking to your heart, not your emotion. Lord, I just thank you now, Father. I thank you now, Lord, that everyone, Lord God, that's in denial of even self, Lord God, they don't know who they are, Lord God. You will show them who they are after tonight's call. You will show them who they are, Lord God. You will bring to them a light, Lord God, like they never seen before. Lord God, we bind up every other thing, Lord God, is unlike you. Every other religion, Lord God, that tries to copycat you, Lord God. We come against the enemy, Lord God. We come against the dark places, Lord God. We fight not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and wickedness in high places. We thank you now, Lord God, that you have given us a sword, Lord God, the sword of righteousness, Lord God. We have a divine reason to be here on earth, Lord God. We're not just born just to be born. We don't die just to die, Lord God. In this creation, Lord God, we're here for such a time as this to make a stake in the ground. We thank you now, Lord God, that this stake in the ground, Lord God, will leave, Lord God, something behind. Lord God, we thank you right now, Father God, for those that have children, Lord God, that you will allow us, Lord God, to move, Lord God, in our children's life, Lord God, so they won't make the wrong decisions, that we will have a voice in their spirit, Lord God, so they will listen to their parents, Lord God, not the teacher, not the friends. Lord God, we bind up every gang member right now in the name of Jesus that goes out, Lord God, to do an act, Lord God, upon what the gang has told them to do for initiation. We come against everything, Lord God, right now that the gang, Lord God, has done, Lord God, to those, Lord God, right now. Lord, I thank you, Father God, for allowing me to watch certain things, Lord God, so I know what to pray for. I thank you now, Lord God, that in this season, Lord God, it will be your mighty men and women, Lord God, that will step up, Lord God. There will be men and women of valor that will do, Lord God, a great work, that will do things, Lord God, that will even shock those, Lord God, that known them yesterday, Lord God. I thank you that you are God that can change things in an instance, Lord God. You can change things. Well, Lord God, we don't need, Lord God, someone, Lord God, that say they think. We know that you can. We thank you, Lord God, you can do all things through Christ, which is you, who strengthens us. We thank you for your strength. We just give it all over to you, Lord God. Lord God, I just ask you to forgive us for our sins, knowing and unknowingly, Lord God. Omission or commission of sins. We thank you, Lord God, that they are thrown away, Lord God, in the sea of forgiveness. We thank you, Lord God, right now that you, Lord God, and you only, Lord God, will guide and lead us and teach us, Lord God. You have a GPS on our heart, on our spirit, Lord God. But it's us, Lord God, that need to chime in and listen, Lord God. Tune into the frequency, Lord God, that you have called us to tune into. And we just thank you right now, Lord God, as we tune in, Lord God, you will lead and guide us, Lord God. We will never, Lord God, be forsaken by you, because it's you, Lord God. It's you, Lord God. It's you, Lord God, that moves in us, Father. We just need to continue, Lord God, to hear and listen, be in a quiet place, that we would know, Lord God, that it is you speaking. You said, Lord God, that your sheep hear your voice and a stranger would depart. Lord God, I declare that we are the sheep, Lord God, of the righteous one. We are the sheep of the Lord Almighty. We thank you now, Father. We give you the glory. We give you the praise. We praise your holy name. You are worthy. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy. We thank you now, Lord God, that every tumor, Lord God, shall dry up in the name of Jesus. Every headache, Lord God, every headache will be healed. Touch your head and say, I'm healed. Every back spasm be healed in the name of Jesus. Every foot, Lord God, we thank you now, Lord God. Every ankle, Lord God, that's hurting right now, touch your ankle and say, be healed. Lord God, we thank you for stomach viruses being healed right now. We thank you, Lord God. We bind up the spirit of Leviathan and incubus and succubus right now. Thank you, Lord God. We thank you right now, Father. Oh, glory to your name. I just stir up the spirit in everyone that's listening right now. I stir up that spirit so they can call in. Call in tonight. 641-715-3580. The access code is 805-700-POUND. We thank you, Lord God, right now. As everyone begin to pray tonight, Lord God, those things, Lord God, that's attached to them, Lord God, those mind-boggling spirits, those heavy shoulders, those ears, Lord God, that's shut, those eyes, Lord God, that's closed, will be open tonight, Lord. I thank you now, Father God, that all, Lord God, that we've gone through, Lord God, is for a reason, Lord God, and it's just a season. It was a test, Lord God, to see if we hold on to you. Lord God, we thank you, Father, right now. We just give you all the glory. We just lift everything up, Lord God, that's not right. We give it over to you, Lord God, and we don't take it back. We thank you right now. We thank you, Lord God, that everything that was hidden, Lord God, will be brought to the light. We thank you, Lord God, that every president, Lord God, that's a part of the skull and bones, Lord God, that, Lord God, that's a part of that secret society, Lord God, everything will be exposed in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord God, right now, as we live in the world of deception, Lord God. You said in your word that you will not allow your saints to be ignorant to Satan's devices. I thank you, Lord God, right now that we are being in a place, Lord God. We have been called to a place, Father God, that the light, Lord God, is shining and is shining bright upon us, Lord God. It will show us, Lord God, things, Lord God, that will amaze us. But, Lord God, and the things that you have shown us, allow us to be able to react and respond in a correct manner. We thank you, Lord God, right now that it's you, Lord God, that allow us to see things, Lord God. And it's also you, Lord God, that allows things to happen, Lord God, to see if we where we are, to see if we where we say we are. Lord God, there's so many that say they're the righteousness, Lord God. There's so many that say that they have faith, Lord God. There's so many, Lord God, that say they have a good heart, Lord God. Well, Lord God, try and test our hearts, as your word says, Lord God. You try and test us each and every day, Lord. We thank you right now, Father God, that it's you, Lord God, that will cause a thing to happen, to see where we are. Chikara rabo je la mama na kochi. Ila rabo je mama ma kashiki aborobobo. Every cancer, ikorobobasha, of any kind, ikoroli abajeke siko. I speak to you now, and I say, leave, leave the body, ikorobababashiki. I thank you, larara bojelari, larabobo shikina. Lord, tikorobobo kashikina. Lord, fill this phone line, ikorobu larara shikida bro. Lord, fill Facebook Live, ikarara shikibi. Lord, the spectators, Lord God, send the wave their way, Lord God. Send the heat, Lord God. Send a chill their way so that they know that you are Lord and Lord over their life as well. We thank you right now, Father God. The enemy tries to come and steal, kill, and destroy, but he has no power. He has no power. He has no power. We thank you that our power comes from you, Lord God. It comes from above, Lord God. And it causes us, Lord God, to be endured with your power being due, Lord God, with that due. Lord God, we thank you for the spirit of the Holy Spirit, Lord God. We thank you for the Holy Ghost, Lord God, that breaks and corrects, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you have called us forth out of the mother's womb, Lord God. You, Lord God, calls us, Lord God, into a place, Lord God, of travail, a place, Lord God, that we're kicking against the bricks, a place, Lord God, where it's uncertainty, Lord God. But we thank in you, Lord God, everything is perfect, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, even when we're going through a trial or tribulation, Lord God, we know that you have caused things to happen, so we're going to be of good cheer. You said, Lord God, the world, Lord God, the world does not understand you, Lord God, but you have placed a spirit within us, Lord God, that can understand who you are and who we are in you. We thank you now. He la da raje mara rejepokona. He la da robo je miki e la da rabo ribate. Horoja lorji la boro chikena. Horoje boro ja mataka de kechu. Hedi korobo shiki hararababa shiki. The aneurysm. I korobo shiki harashira raboku. I send it back to the thought. I koroba bakashi. To the one that tried to place it upon you. I koroba bakashi. The aneurysm. I kararashiki. It shall not prosper. In the name of Jesus, we thank you now, Lord God. I koroba bakashi. We call every organ to be straightened. We thank you, Lord God. Oh, we give you praise. We give you praise, Lord God. Oh, we lift you up, Lord God. You said you be lifted up, Lord God. You said we lift you up, you draw men all unto us, Lord God. We just ask, Lord God, not only that the men, Lord God, the women be drawn, Lord God, but so we be able to be a good steward, Lord God, so we can convert them, Lord God, so they know, so that they may know that you are their king, you are their God, you are their father, you are the one, Lord God, who brings life to them, Lord God. Lord God, there's so many people out there that are so confused, Lord God, don't know where they come from, Lord God. And they just listen to every doctrine, Lord God, every erroneous doctrine, Lord God, that sounds good, that sounds great. Evolution, Lord God, we come against everything, Lord God, that's not like you. We just thank you right now, Father God, that you will do a new thing, Lord God. Even though your word says you change not, you the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, Lord God. But you said you should do a new thing, you should spring forth, Lord God, water, Lord God, in the deserts. We thank you, Lord God, God, right now that we're in a desert situation, Lord God. We thank you as we push forward and move, Lord God, in the, throughout January, Lord God. By the end of January, Lord God, it will be some things, Lord God, that's going on. It will be promotions, Lord God. It will be signs and wonders from you, Lord God. Because you said in the last days, your spirit will be poured out on all flesh, men, women, Lord God, babies, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you said your young men shall see dreams or shall have dreams, Lord God. I thank you now that Rabo Shiki shall have visions, Lord God. I thank you now, Lord God. Tiki Ojoba Badeke Chita Horaba Babaka She Ida Raba. I come against homosexuality right now in the name of Jesus. I say, be straight, be healed, listen. Hear what the word of God is saying. You are made for a reason. You are made to be Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve. I thank you now, Lord God, that spirit, Lord God, of perversion, Lord God, that spirit of homosexuality, Lord God, will be broken. The hand of the band, the back, the thought of Satan has been broken in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord God, that I speak not just with my words, Lord God, not with power nor might, but by your spirit alone. I thank you now, Lord God. He called Rabo Richi Lara Bababakichi, Horobo Lika Murashi, Abababakashi, Halarashi, Hopo. Whoever name is Carmichael, Carmichael, the Lord has called you Carmichael. Halarabili Koji Mala Juta Mama Tekeda. Araba Jubu Bubushiki, Carmichael, Hopo Rababakashiki, Dara. The Lord says, come forth. He kada rabu jububuku baladara kishi. Hala rababakshiki Carmichael. Ubu rababakashi. The Lord seeing you crying. The buruba babakashi. Ilara rababakushi. Carmichael. Ubu rubu babakashiki. Ala rababasha. You shall live and not die. Ilala rubu shila burubu bukushi. Oh, we worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. Oh, we worship you, Jesus. Oh, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy. You're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy. I speak life to relationships. I speak restoration to relationships. Glory to Jesus. Restoration in families. I thank you, Lord God, for restoring families, Lord God, restoring the mindset. Lord God, when people come against us, Lord God, we will still be able to stand strong, Lord God, and know that the salvation of the Lord, Lord God, is within you, Lord God. The salvation of the Lord is within us, Lord God. And with those two together, Lord God, you say, he that's in us, which is you, is greater than he that's in this world. We thank you, Lord God, that salvation, Lord God, has come unto us, Lord God, to make us whole, to pull us out of anything, Lord God, that we can't even think that we can be put out of her. But we thank you, Lord, that it's because of you, Lord God. It's because of your spirit that we've been made whole. We've been set free. We've been made free from the things that Satan has tried to place upon us, the things that the enemy has tried to do. We thank you now, Lord God. Oh, we thank you now. We glorify your name. We glorify your name. You're worthy to be praised. We enter in right now, Lord God. And as we entered in, Lord God, we thank you for welcoming us to your courts. We thank you now, Lord God. And as we wail and pray, Lord God, as we lament, Lord God, we thank you that you will hear us, Lord, that you will do a thing, Lord God. Chela chopate kada. Hekito da boro jekinu. Hala rabo jela da rabala de shito. Hala robo ke la bache a bobo shito. The Lord says to worship him now. Everyone that had a burden, he got a roja malake chuda bobo koni. Everyone that felt heavy. Everyone that had a pain, it shall be gone now. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your spirit. Where the spirit of God is, liberty rests. We thank you, Lord God, right now for the resting of your spirit, for the healing that's taking place right now. We thank you, Lord. Oh, glory, glory, glory. Hala raje boroshe bababakani. Horo balera raje mamamatoro shokuma. Hala raleda boroje metara rabababako. Chilara rababa. Eko borobo elaba ekishidobada ke. Glory to your name, Lord. Oh, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy. Oh, how we adore you, Lord God. Oh, we magnify your name, Yahshua. Hallo rejeme joa ra reshi. Uru ala re luru. Chila reboko mala rashiki. Uru ala rashi. Ora raboke sho. Urulare loro bashi. Hararaba kurushe la rabo kurile da boro bikararashu. Lord, we worship you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord God. Everything that's been going on, Lord God, we know, Lord God, you've been seeing it. You've been seeing the earthquakes, Father. You've been seeing the fires. You've been seeing the molestation, Lord God. You've been seeing the trafficking. Lord, we thank you, Lord God. Oh, Lord, we thank you, Lord. Huria quale quesiki a baratako bati. Huruli a la rale o rubo qua mia le shiki. They think they have a plan. Haruba le kura shiki da badado qua meti. But I am the master planner. Ikio wa hapo a tiki. Hato a shiki da taka. I told them time and time and time to stop it. Iko rubo ka shiki. That my wrath is going across the earth. Ikio ruba chaka. Many shall fall. Iko ruba bakashi. And I shall raise up a new remnant. Iko rubo boku shiki da. For the time is now. The Lord thy God has spoken, this is the hour that the earth shall tremble and tremble loud. Get yourselves right with me. The time is read out. As I told you before, I am not the God of fear, but I am the God of excellence. You shouldn't fear me. Shiki, those that are rashi that fear me don't know me. He koruba la da raba babakashiki hararabo. He la da raba bakashi habu raba bakashiki. It's time to turn things around. It's time to get your lives right. The time is short. And you will know when things begin to turn your life. When things don't seem the same anymore. When things begin to get hard. When you can't think. When fear has taken control. And it's been the forerunner in your life. That's an indication that you're off track. In order to be on track, fear will not be running side by side. In order to be on track, you will speak life and not death. In order to be on track, you will forgive those who curse you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. I think I prayed now for about 30 minutes. I'm going to open up the floor now for others to chime in. Because as you pray, we're touching heaven tonight. Heaven is going to be bombarded tonight. And when praises go up, blessings come down. And everyone that open their mouth, it will be heard tonight. Believe that. It will be heard tonight. Believe that. You will be seen by heaven. You will be touched by heaven tonight. The heavens are open. Your voice will be heard. It's a deep well right now. Horobo shelara rababakashe hiko hupate horiki is welling up ikoroba sheke. It's a deep well. You need to get in the well. Get in the water. Get in the water. Rebore jela docho boka hela rabakasheke. The water is troubled. Ikoroba chekeda horobo boko she hela rab. The blessings. I see a streamline. Ikorobo like a rainbow. Ika shakaraboko. Hurashe a boroche kimini. Huruba babakashe a kamura beketo. Huruba balakasheke mama tokosheke. Haraboche iko a babakateke na maraba bakateke. Lord, thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Your ears will be open tonight. You begin to hear. You're going to begin to hear things like you never heard before. You're going to begin to see like you never seen before. Those crooked places will become straight. Every promotion in this hour will be done. Will be done. Will be spoke about by March. By March, right now, January, things are going inside of a room. I see a room and I see names. I see people talking. But by March, it's going to be set in stone. You will know who you are in the promotional realm right now. It's a promotional realm that's going on right now. It's a promotion that's going on. And by March, some may know already what's going on. But by March, I keep hearing March. By March 8th,
thank you, Jesus.
Pora le kureja pabo riki ore bushe hala rababa kosheke. You hold on to your faith like never before. This month is very critical. It's a critical month. This month is very critical. This month you got to hold on to. Whatever goes on, whoever tries to come against you, hold on and love them to death. Love them back. Love them. Because if you don't love them, you're going to miss it. Right now is critical. What happens in the month of January will continue for the rest of the year. Horicho rabo de cache, ikorubaba tekara robo, liki nama, horishela robo, bokoshiki. Hold on to this word, ikoruba leke. The Lord says, so many of his people forget his word. Atiko bacheke, robo bobo. So many forget his word. If somebody is having like an issue with their mind, they go back and forth. It's like they feel like they're schizophrenic, but the Lord says he's healing you tonight. Huruba je aboruchi kubura mamamoko. Huruburi ababashi. Huruchala reboruba mokushiki naba. The Lord also says somebody on this call that's interpreting what I'm saying right now.
Thank you, God.
The enemy has set up a trap. But as you begin to praise him, your praise is your protection. The Lord is pressing in on you. The Lord is pressing in so that you can go to your spiritual account. You must press in to God now. Lord, we thank you, Lord God. We pray for every house, every apartment, every condo, Lord God, every cottage, Lord God. We thank you right now, Lord God. I'm just sending the heads of protection over them. I send the angels, Lord God. We ask that your angels right now, Lord God, will be released for each and every person, Lord God, right now. We thank you, Lord God, that they will move on assignment, Lord God, as you have called them to be, Lord God, to heal, to direct, to correct, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that the financial angel has been released in the name of Jesus. The healing angel has been released in the name of Jesus, in the name of Yahshua HaMashiach. We thank you. We send notice to the enemy. We send notice. Those that's going right now in the battle that's fighting, you just know that it's not flesh, that it's the spirit. It's a spirit that's trying to come against you. It's a spirit that's trying to get you weak. It's a spirit that's trying to confuse you. But we fight not against flesh and blood, but principalities and wickedness in high places. We thank you, Lord God, that you're sending us, Lord God, to another heaven. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that we're one body, one mind, Lord God. The Father, Son, the Holy Spirit is freedom. And we thank you, Lord God, right now that we're free. We're free from bondage. We're free, Lord God, from any sickness, Lord God. We thank you now, Lord God. We free, Lord God, from debt. Lord God, we thank you now, Father. We just turn it all over to you, Lord God, and you say, make it right. Make it right. Make it right. The Lord says, be a good steward over what I have given you. And that's not just money, but it's your soul. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Can someone else pray? I've been praying for 40 minutes. Can somebody else pray right quick?
I got you, brother. I got you. Heavenly Father, I just thank you right now for everything you have done. Protect over each and everybody on this phone, God. I give you the worship, honor, and glory to you and your son. Thank you for just hearing us right now, God. Speak life over everybody that's speaking on this phone, everybody that's on the prayer line, everybody that's on Facebook Live, God. Every one of our hearts, come into each and every one of our hearts, God. I thank you for everything you have done. Forgive me of my sins as I repent daily, God. Touch those at the job, touch those that's traveling, touch those that's sick, homeless, touch each and every one of us, Father God. Find the demons up to hell where they all belong, God. Forgive each and every one of us out here. Daily, Father God.
Shilara, Father.
Each and every one of our hearts, God.
Ori Corice Keborra.
Everybody is falling, but we asking you, God, to wake us up. Protect us, guide us, give us the strength to keep fighting the good fight. Sorry, God, for all the things we do daily. Repentance like St. David repented daily, God.
Yes.
Thank you, God, for everything you have done and you're doing for us tomorrow. Thank you for waking us up, God. I worship you, God. I honor you. I adore you. I'm sorry, God. I'm sorry for the things I have done. Forgive us all, Father God.
Yes.
Look over Derek. Look over Mistake. Look over Caleb. Look over me. Look over Wayne. Look over Liz. Look over everybody. Maribel, Chris, everybody at my job, my mom, my little sister, every one of us, Father
yes,
God. Kill us with that protection, that blood, Father God.
Yes, Lord.
Speak life over everybody's life.
Yes, Lord.
I speak, God, to save us, to protect over us. Keep each and every one of us in the Lamb's book of life.
Yes, Jesus.
Father God, we don't know if tonight is our last night, but I will worship you like it was my last, Father God.
Yes,
the music playing in the ground, extra strength, Father God, to cover us with armor so we can fight the good fight, God. Thank you, God. I thank you for everything you have done. I worship you for everything you have done for me. Father, forgive me for my sin, God. Protect over me, God. Because I feel to your throne, ask for ask for your grace, Father God. I ask for your mercy. Save
yes,
us. I pray for the peace of Jerusalem. They shall prosper that love you, God.
Yes, Lord.
Give those that my job. Look over Ray. Look over Bishop. Look over each and every one of us right now, God. We worship you, God.
Yes, Lord God. We worship
you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I'm sure, just like everybody else. That's not one right.
Yes, Lord.
By your grace, God. By your grace, we're still alive.
Yes, Lord. Continue to watch us.
Forgive those in leadership, God. Forgive each and everyone.
Yes, Lord, God.
But we know now. Give us that shalom peace tonight, God. That we stay in your presence. I love you, God. I'm truly sorry. Your son, your servant, you're my master. I really believe back with all my heart, God. Don't you forget that I repent and surrender daily. Touch each and every one of us to the crown of our head, to the soul of our I love you. Deliver us from evil. The kingdom power, the glory of now, forever, and ever. Jesus Christ, God, amen.
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 Now, those that joined late, we've been,
oh, God.
We're going to heaven tonight, and heaven is coming to us. We've been praying, we've been going in, and the Lord has commissioned me to just go all in tonight. And I pray for 40 minutes straight. And now I'm opening up the floor for everyone else to pray. Because as you pray, it's going to be released. January is a critical month. What happens in January is going to be basically your lifeline for the rest of the year. And I trust, I believe, and I know that as long as you get things straight, that you line things up in January, that the rest of the year is going to be the best of the year. Believe what I'm saying. Someone else want to pray?
Yeah, I'll pray.
All right.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God. Yes, God.
Oh, God. Yeah, God.
Oh, I've been feeling in my spirit all day. There is a bomb in Gilead.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah. Today, 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 today. Oh, God. As I walk around now, I'm walking around heaven, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
Lord. Oh, God, I ask that you will come and intervene, Lord God.
Yes.
Come before the throne of grace, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thanking you, glorifying your name, not asking for anything, Lord God. Just
yes.
Thank you.
Oh, yes.
I thank you, I thank you, I thank you, I thank you. You deserve the worship and the praise, Lord God.
Yes.
You deserve the honor, Lord God. And, oh, God, I intercede for everybody else, Lord Jesus. I come a sinner. I'm worthy of your presence and your faith. Asking for forgiveness, first of all, for myself, Lord. Cleanse my heart, my soul, my mind, my spirit, Lord God. And, oh, God, I forgive those who have wronged me, and I ask that those I've wronged will forgive me, Lord Jesus. And, oh, God, I ask that you would teach me to have a humble heart, Lord God. Let me live the Beatitudes out, Lord Jesus. Ask that you would give me the right words to say to someone else to help them along their journey, Lord God. Oh, God, I ask that you would fix the brokenness in this country, Lord God. Lord God, let people learn to love on one another, Lord Jesus. Don't harbor in the hate, the pain, and the anger. You can be angry with somebody and they don't even know why you feel angry with them anymore. Anger will kill you. Anger will stress you out. And, oh, God, I just thank you for the job that I have. I thank you for my apartment. I thank you for my car. It's not what I want, but I have it, and I know it's because of you. Everything I have, I submit back over to you, Lord God. I pray for my children, my children's children, my family, everyone that's on this prayer call, everybody that's attacked us shall win. Our prayer, they will win. Our families will be saved. We shall win. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yay, God. And just like you said, January is different. It's been a different month since it started. It's been a different month since the past. It's just been different completely. Nobody understands. If you're going through this, why are you still smiling? If I don't smile, I'm going to cry. I'd rather smile than cry.
Oh, yeah, God.
And like I tell somebody else, you don't know my story. I don't know your story. But I say thank you.
Oh, thank you.
I woke up this morning. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Breathe the breath of life into my nostrils once again to give me the opportunity to tell somebody else. But God. But God. My purpose, but God. But God. If I got to lean over, I'm going to get up and say, yes.
Breakthrough.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, fill her, Lord God. Fill her, Holy Spirit. Fill her. As you, I see that stream again. I see that stream. It's a stream of healing. The enemy thought he had you. But God, travail in the spirit. We bring healing.
Travail.
Lord, we need you, Lord God. We enter in, Lord God. We're here, Lord God, just prostrate before you in the spirit. We thank you, Lord God, that we're thinking of nothing but you, Lord God. We have not thought of our children. We have not thought of a bill. We have not thought of a sickness, our health problems, Lord God, nothing. We're thinking of you, Lord God. So therefore, Lord God, download in us, Lord God, the blessings of heaven, Lord God. Download in us, Lord God, the blessings that you have stored up for us, Lord God. We receive them now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Boriki ela chokateka manekita. Horoshiki maro. Those that's not travailing, those that's not praying, you need to pray now. The water is troubled. Jump in the water.
Hallelujah.
The Spirit of God is pushing on some of you. The Spirit of God is pushing on some of you. Yes, he's pushing some things out of you too. He's pushing on you to push him through you, to push him out. We must go in. We must go in. This is a crucial month. This is a crucial month. Somebody else want to pray?
I would, Derek.
Christian?
Yeah. As you was, as my son was talking, I felt warm. And I felt that he has you, and I see him with his arm on you.
Hmm.
Mm. He's watching you as you go to work. He's watching you while you're in your house, while you're crying to him. He's watching you, and because of your obedience, he is going to reward you this year. I see, as you talk, I can hear, and I see things flowing.
Hallelujah.
And a lot of times, I think about you heavy, and I know why, because of your faith. And Derek, to touch back on what you said at the beginning about Mark, because I told Mom the same thing not too long ago. I told her that Mark is the month of promotion. I see her getting a promotion. I had a dream that she had a promotion. Everybody says, this is my year. This is my season. He is rewarding.
Yes. Yes, Holy Spirit. Oh, we thank you, Holy Spirit. The fire of God is here tonight. The fire of God is here to heal. The fire of God is to break every stronghold right now. Every stronghold will be broken tonight. Healing is present tonight. Not saying that healing wasn't present the other days, but the water is troubled. It's the fire, the fire, the fire, the fire. We worship you, Father. We worship you, Father. We worship you, Father. Have your way. Have your way, Father. Have your way, Father. We receive total healing. I speak now the manifestation of the healing. Our minds, our mouths, what we have read. We've seen that God says he's a healer. We've seen and read that he says by your stripes you are healed. But Lord, we ask for the manifestation of that healing now. The words that we read, the words that we believe, the words that we have spoken, that the manifestation will reach the body now. In Yahshua's name, receive it. Yes. Get lost in the Spirit. Get lost in the Spirit. Get lost in the Spirit. Roxanna, the Lord has said he's seen your faithfulness. Si a la robo likoshiki. Your faithfulness has reached heaven, and it didn't reach heaven tonight. It's been up there, but it's been an enemy has fought you to try to throw you down, to try to trip you up, to try to make you feel that you're not worthy, that you're less than. But God says you're more than. When he said you're less, that means you're more. Whatever the enemy says to you is always the opposite. The Lord says to continue to come, continue to fast and pray and worship, and you're going to see the mighty hand of God move some things out of your way this year. Somebody else want to pray?
Hey, how are you?
Good.
Today, I was at work. I was calling mom. I felt like I was being attacked today because of at my job. They were saying I wasn't doing what I was supposed to do, but I know every day I spent hours out doing what I thought was right. So she told me today that my job is on the line, and I'm like, but I've been every day. I just wasn't fasting just for that one time.
Well, okay. You're being attacked because you want to do the right thing, but you haven't been doing the right thing. And if that makes sense to you, I believe you know what I mean. But God says he wants all of you or nothing at all. You remember the scripture where it talks about being lukewarm, hot or cold?
Mm-hmm.
He wants you to be hot for him and hot on him. As you are hot on his trails, going after him like never before, cutting everything out that you know that's a distraction, cutting everything out that you know that's not God, he's going to turn everything around. He didn't move you over there. You didn't get that job to lose that job. But he's trying to rattle your feet. He's trying to rattle your spirit. He's trying to get you to where you're supposed to be. But for whatever reason, you're not going in like you're supposed to. You're being distracted by something, and God is saying that distraction must be gone. That distraction must cease. And as that distraction ceases, he's going to show you a little bit by little. He's inch by inch. I see an inchworm. It's not going to happen overnight for you, because if it happens overnight, you will forget who he is. You know who he is. But you won't continue to do the things. You won't continue in the things of the Lord as he had called you to. He has called you. You have even spoken out of your mouth that you want this. That you have spoken, you have entered the battlefield. That you have entered the battlefield, you can't go back. Because now you have an enemy that's after your soul, after your health, and after your job. But it is so that the Lord will restore everything unto you after you make your decision tonight. Your decision tonight would be that of the Lord. I want everything that you want for me. And what you don't want for me, I don't want. Make a decision tonight and watch the hand of the Lord move on your behalf.
Amen.
Yes, Lord. Now I want you to pray. Yeah.
God, I thank you for who and what you are in my life. Jesus, I thank you for, we all thank you for who and what we are, what you are in our life, Jesus. Without you, we're nothing, Jesus. Jesus, I thank you for you bringing me this far. Without you, I wouldn't be here, Jesus. I wouldn't be in this place, point, and time. I wouldn't be here, Jesus, if it was not for you, Jesus. I thank you for what, from what you have, from what you have brought me to. I thank you for what you gave me. Jesus, I just thank you. I can't thank you enough. I thank you for my life. I thank you for my life, self-strength, Jesus. I thank you for everything. I thank you for Jesus, I can't thank you enough for what you have been in my life, Jesus. Without you, I'm nothing, Jesus. Mm-hmm. We're nothing.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Sorry to the people who does not believe in you, Jesus. Sorry, Jesus.
Gorali orishi la rabo roshi. Here rabo boko.
They have no idea what you can do, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
You are ruler of all evil.
Yes, Lord.
When the doctor says that you have something, when the doctor tells somebody that they have something, you come back around and turn it back over and say, no, you don't have it.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Jesus, I just thank you for what you do in each of our lives, Jesus. Without you, we're nothing, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Someone else want to pray? We have another prayer.
Father God, we thank you that we wake up every morning.
Yes, Lord.
That you allow us to be on here on this journey one more day. Father God, we thank you for the air and the perfect world that you've created for us.
Yes.
We're all just one of your blessings, one of your little miracles. Father God, thank you for testing us. Father God, thank you for testing us to be stronger, to come out, to see if we still stay with you. Father God, thank you for giving us friends that iron sharpens iron. That's why we have close friends that we keep together. The ones that we aren't supposed to be with anymore, they go. And you make us realize more and more as we get older and older that the closer the friends, the more they strengthen us, the more they sharpen us, the more they enlighten us, the more they keep us with you. Father God, thank you for this every Thursday that you've given us for two years plus, that you've taken our blessings and had to hear our prayers. And every time I ask you to give my strength to my brother and to give his pathetic word out, you do so. Even if it gets me sick as a dog, I know it's the best of all worlds. Father God, I thank you for blessing me with my children. Father God, thank you for just keeping us alive and keeping us in your presence. It's only through you, and it's only but God, everything. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for everything. There's not enough time to give you thanks. Every morning, we must thank you. Every night, we must thank you. We got to remember that we are here because of you and only you, O Father God. And because of this, it is right to give you thanks and praise. Father God, we thank you for every little thing in this world that you have given us and given us strength to. Even the tests, even the bad times. And we know that we shall overcome because thank you for giving your one and only Son to die on that cross for our sins.
Jesus.
The one thing that we come into this world sin-free because of his blood is his life that you have allowed us to be in a different world, in different times. Although things still are the same on a lot of forefronts, Father, and you know that the fighting always is there. As it was always in the beginning, until the days that we get to where we were just the Adam and Eve without the serpent. Lord, you know when that time is. Lord, we just keep. ourselves right and with you. And we love you. And we always need you. And we just always ask of this through the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Please bless everybody that's hearing this and under the sound of my voice and people that are on the Facebook Live and everywhere around the world that believes in you and the ones that don't believe in you. Please, you'll show them because every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that you are Lord when the time comes and the time is coming. Yes. And we know this and we want to be with you, O Lord. Thank you. We love you. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. We have another prayer.
Yes, there is Myra.
Hey, Myra.
Hey, just want to say thank God for this call tonight. And just want to start off by saying, God, we come humble to the throne of grace tonight.
Yes, Lord God.
First of all, just saying thank you. God,
yes, Lord.
I just want to thank you. I want to ask you to forgive me for everything that I've ever done wrong, said, anything that I have ever said to anyone. Even if I hurt you something that I didn't know, God, forgive me.
Yes, Lord God.
Lord, thank you for allowing me the opportunity to have a job to go back after 3 months of being off the surgery.
Yes.
And God, I just thank you for my co-workers, for my family. Thank you for my children. Both my children were on a call tonight. Even before I remember. And God, I just ask you to just continue to watch over us, continue to bless us, continue to watch over the shepherd over this prayer call. God, you said you give us, excuse me, as we obey the call, you will give us and show us your all. Bless everyone under the sound of his voice. We thank you. We love you. We praise you, God. Just continue to keep us covered with your blood.
Yes.
Our families, I love you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
In Jesus' name, amen. Jesus' name, amen. This has been beautiful. We have touched heaven tonight. Heaven has been awakened, and blessings have reached earth. And I believe that.
And Derek.
Huh?
I'm sorry. Play for Marvella. Marvella had nasty falls on Tuesday so bad that she was getting out of her daycare van, adult daycare van, and the guy of the van didn't help her out. She fell out of the van face first. Not on her head, her forehead scarred up, her nose scarred up, and knocked all her teeth out at the bottom. And I was just telling Christian, I would talk to Derek, and I told him, I wish I could have, have taken that on, because Marvella, for people who know her, she's 61 years old, she's been having seizures since she was 5 years old. When I tell you that she has gone through some things, I wish I could have taken that, because it's just so much to get through. So just keep her in your prayers. I'm just going to ask God to do it. And I'll leave it as that. But just for those who know her, my sister, her name is Marcella, just keep her lifted up in prayer. Thank you.
Father, we come before you right now, Lord God, as a body, Lord God, as a garrison, as a fleet. We just bombard heaven, Lord God, as we have already entered into your courts, as we've been welcomed into your courts. We thank you, Lord God, that not only, Lord God, will you keep my Vella as you've been keeping her, but Lord God, steer her mind back right on you, Lord God, like it was, like I remember. Like how she used to listen to her gospel tapes. That's all she did all day long. We know she loves you, Lord. Be kalaraboche. Lord, that spirit that tries to attach itself, Lord God, I twist it up 7 times. Lord, I thank you, Father God, that you are greater. You are the great I am. You are the head, Lord God, of every demonic force that's out here now. You are the King of glory. Lord, and we worship you, Lord God, and demons fear you. Lord, I thank you now, Father, that you will continue, Lord God, to be that helper for my Marvella, Lord God, to be the one that her inner being seeks after, Lord God. Lord God, I go and speak to that flesh, that spirit, and I say to that spirit to release her now in the name of Jesus. I come against you with vengeance. With the spirit of God, with the host of the Lord behind me. Torment no more, torment no more, torment no more. I go to the depths of her mind, to the depths of her spirit. And everything that's not you, God, I ask to leave. You demon, you sorcerer, you wizard. You incubus spirit. I say, be gone now. The Lord rebukes you. You have no right nor place. I, with the Spirit of God, come against everything that's not right. In Jesus' name, we pray, amen.
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 Anybody else?
I'll pray.
Okay.
Father God, we come before you thanking you for your mercy and grace upon our soul. We thank you for allowing us to wake up this morning, Father God. And I take that for granted because there's some people that were called home. Father God, I just want to thank you for everything that you've done in my life, in my family's life, and the easy transition that you've placed before me to go back to work and to have Caleb cared for by my sister, Father God. You put everything in place and made it so easy for me and for Derek. And I thank you for that. And I will forever, ever praise you for that, Father God. Father God, I thank you for Derek. I thank you for his obedience. I thank you for the love he has for you and what he has helped me get through, Father God. Father God, every Thursday he's so obedient being on these calls, Father God, and I see how much he loves and adores you, Father God, and I just ask you to continue to stay close to him, protect him, Father God, as he's constantly praying for people, and we all need to continue to pray for him, Father God. Father God, I ask for traveling mercies. As you know, I travel an hour back and forth to work, and Derek travels 2 to 3 hours, and I ask you to continue to cover our family as we travel back and forth in our distance.
Yes, Lord God.
Caleb. Father God, I love you. I love everything. I love you for the ups and even the downs, Father God. I will never be complacent in my life because I know that
prayer
and desire for your word, for the fullness of your word, Father God. Every single day I will commit to listening and reading and continuing to be obedient in my life. God, you called us to celibacy, and celibacy we are, Father God, and we will continue to be till we are united as one, Father God. Father God, I love you. I thank you. I thank you for everybody on this call. For every Thursday, even newcomers, Father God. But Father God, I thank you for the people who've prayed for me and Derek as we've had our ups and downs ourselves, Father God, but that's what makes us strong. Did you say a family that prays together, stays together, Father God, and we will continue to pray and teach our son Caleb what it is to be in your presence, Father God. Father God, I love all my brothers and sisters in Christ, and I thank you, Father God, for my family, for my sister Linda, who has been such great support to me and Derek, and who has taken on Caleb like that's her own son, Father God. Father God, I thank you for everyone who continues to reach out and ask how we're doing and see and be there for us, Father God. Father God, I just thank you for my job, for the things that, as I said before, you put in place.
you know, you allowed my job to take me back to work. Even when I exhausted my disability, they took me back. But I know that wasn't their doing. That was your doing. Yes. You put everything in place for us, Father God. And I thank you for that, Father God. I thank you for my health. I thank you for everyone's health on this call and everyone's family, Father God. I love you. I worship you. I praise you every single day. You are my best friend. You are my father. You are the love of my life, and I thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Anybody else would like to pray? Remember, as you pray, it's going to be a release because you're opening your mouth. We hear a closed mouth don't get fed, but the Spirit of God told me a closed mouth don't get understood. You must allow yourself to be free from fear and be free to speak. And also, one other thing, a closed mouth don't get understood. We must speak things into existence, not think it. We must speak it. We must speak it. A closed mouth don't get understood. Allow that self, that strong peace inside of you, that worry inside of you. Because remember, you're into the war once you have accepted Christ. So if you don't fight back, you're going to lose. The kingdom of heaven suffered violence, but the violence took it by force. We took it by force. Ronnie, V3, what's up, brother? Oh my God, it's been since what, 93, 94 since I seen you. Wow, man, call me on Facebook Messenger in a little while when I get off of this call. Oh man. We must continue to go in because this is a critical month. But it's a lot of things that's set in place for each and every last one of us if we go in, if we open our mouth. We have to open our mouth, though. That's why he has me doing this right now once a month to pray and everyone chime in. And as we chime in together, we're going in as together, as an army. And when we go in together, guess what? Things happen. Things get overturned. But we're going to do it. We're pulling each other. And I don't want no one to feel like someone's prayer sounds better than the other. Only thing you need to do is talk to God like you're talking to a person. Remember, there's no vainglory over here. There's no perfect prayer. The Pharisees prayed beautifully, but their hearts wasn't intact, in line. Pray out of your heart. Just talk to God. And as you talk to God, he's going to hear you. So does anyone else on here wants to pray? If not, I'll close it out. Father, I come before you right now, Lord God. I just say thank you, Lord God, for everyone that's on this call, everyone that prayed, Lord God, that you will allow heaven, Lord God, to not be someplace up above, Lord God, someplace as a mystery, Lord God, but you will have heaven to be this place, Lord God, where we walk around every day, where we commune with people, Lord. We thank you, Lord God, that heaven, Lord God, is what we make it. Heaven, Lord God, is where we hear that's in the clouds, Lord God, but heaven is yet right here on earth. We thank you, Lord God, right now that we are the righteousness of you because you called us to be righteous. You imputed righteousness in us. We thank you now, Lord God, that every listening ear, Lord God, everyone is going through a storm, Lord God. By the end of this call, Lord God, they will be filled. Release, Lord God, from that fear, Lord God. Release from that that issue, Lord God, that they've been having, Lord God, with their body, with their mind. We thank you now, Lord God, that you will continue to use us, Lord God, in this earth for your glory. And no weapon formed against us shall prosper. We thank you, Lord God, for the children, Lord God, that's coming up in the ranks, Lord God, that they will be safe, Lord God. They will not be caught up in the trafficking, Lord God. And we just ask, Lord God, that every young girl right now, even the boys, Lord God, that's caught up in trafficking, Lord God, that those people that's behind it, Lord God, will be exposed, Lord God. They will be put in jail, Lord God, that will be dealt with, Lord God, for the crimes that they have committed to these children. We thank you, Lord God, right now that the minds, Lord God, of your men and of your women, Lord God, will end up seeing and understanding that it's not just the new world order, Lord God, but it's the Christ. Christ, you are order, Lord God, not the new world order. We come against everything, Lord God, and everybody, Lord God, that thinks about that this here thing that we're going through, this here God that we pray to, is a mystery. No, it's not a mystery. We thank you right now, Lord God, that you will have them, Lord God, to be exposed to who you are. You will give them a chance, give them a shot. Lord God, I don't speak hell to them, Lord God. I just thank you, Lord God, right now that you will do something mysterious, Lord God. You will do something dynamic, Lord God. For they can see and know that you are the God of this earth. You are the God that created them. And we just thank you, Lord God, right now that all things, Lord God, that you have created, Lord God, you will make known to man. And Lord God, we will know that the scientist, Lord God, is looking for something that they can't find. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, amen. And as we leave this call, but not never your presence, Lord God, we thank you now that you will be with each and every last one of us. And I'll just say amen.
Amen.
All right. Well, if no one have any testimonies or anything, we can end the call. Yeah.
My brother Derek, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
My brother. Go ahead, my brother.
God bless everyone that's on the call, and God bless you and your family, and thank you for your prayers.
You know what's
and on behalf of...
You know what's amazing? The Holy Spirit placed you in my spirit tonight, too. And that you called in, now I know you were supposed to pray.
Amen.
And God is going to do something for you because your heart is geared towards God. No matter what happened in the past, all of us have a past. But God said, because of you, keep reaching out to him. Because of your longing for him. You, your girl, your baby is going to be okay. And I pray right now for a head's protection over your child, that that beautiful baby of yours will grow up with the stature of God, with the knowledge of God, with the knowledge to be able to speak eloquently, as well as with the Spirit of God, to be able to change the generation that she will be growing up in. I thank you now.
Hallelujah.
That she will not only bring pleasure to you two, but bring pleasure to many in this world. That she will not be a child that's been forgotten, but she will be a child that plants a stake in the ground for people to have hope. In Jesus' name, I pray, amen.
Hallelujah, amen. Amen.
All right. Okay, I want you to pray now.
My prayer in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
As, and to everyone that's on this phone call and to people who cannot hear my voice, but the word of God from my mouth. And it's for all the children in the world because God has blessed me with my first child. There's children out there in this world that need to feel his presence tonight.
Yes, Lord.
God bless Caleb. God bless my daughter. God bless everyone's child.
Yes, Jesus.
And to know the pain that a parent must feel when their child is not being taken care of. God, please bless these parents and bless these children with nourishment of the soul, of the mind.
Yes, Lord.
God, I'm a selfish person because you made me this way, and you made your warriors so strong. your words that not only are we the strongest, but we are also the weakest, because we believe in the divine power of love, of true love. And that is what you instilled in our blood, in our DNA, in the blood of Christ that is within us as brothers and sisters who share this planet. And thank you, God, for my healing as a human being, as a man. Thank you, God, for everyone who's listening through these words, because they're coming from you.
Yes, Jesus.
I'm just another vessel to share this word. In the Lord's name I pray. And protect everyone on this phone call, everyone's family, everyone's child, every child that is on planet Earth that is suffering at this very moment that needs the reassurance that you're present. In the Lord's name I pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you all.
Amen. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Hey, Joanne. I thought that was you. I know it's cold in Chicago, Joanne. I'll be there in March. I'm going to speak at this church.
Hey.
Kenny. Kenny Johnson, what's up, my brother? Your grandmother's between life and death. We speak life. Father, we come before you right now, Lord God, as I touch and agree, Lord God, with Kenny, Lord God, and Kim. You said, well, there's two or more gathering your name, that you are in the midst of thee. We come and bombard heaven, Lord God, again, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that we're actually still up there, Lord God. We thank you that you hear us, Lord God. You're attentive to us. We thank you, Lord God, that grandma, Lord God, shall breathe, shall live, Lord God, shall laugh. We thank you, Lord God, live, Lord God, live, live, live. Lord God, I thank you right now that Kenny's grandmother, Lord God, will be a testament, Lord God, to those, Lord God, that's around her, her peers, Lord God, for the young people, Lord God. She will be able to come back and speak another word of encouragement. She will be able to stay around, Lord God, to be lifted, Lord God, in such a place, Lord God, that we know that it was you that did it. We thank you, Lord God, not for our sakes, but for your holy name's sake. We thank you, Lord God, right now, as Kenny, Lord God, will submit himself unto you, Lord God, that he will be the one that be able to go and touch his grandmother and restore life, Lord God, and strength to her, Lord God. I thank you now, Father, that Kenny, Lord God, has been called for such a time as this to rise up, Lord God, to go and speak life into his grandmother, Lord God. But I thank you, Lord God, with the spirit that's in me, Lord God, the spirit that you have invested in me, Lord God, that it will touch Kenny's life right now, Lord God. It will touch his hands, Lord God. He will begin to feel something in his body in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord God, I ask, Lord God, you would give him a sign now, Lord God, that he would know, Lord God, that he have the power from above, not the power from below, beneath, not the power of a man, but your power, because you that's in him is greater than he that's in his world. And Lord God, we thank you now that it would be Kenny, Lord God. It would be Kenny's submission, Lord God, that will speak and bring life, restoration, and wholeness to Granny. I thank you. I call it done. I declare and decree it to be so. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Hey,
yep.
Hey, can you pray?
Amen.
What'd you say, Dante?
I said, can you pray for me? But I'm outside of your door, Doctor.
Oh, you outside the door?
Yeah. All right.
Okay, hold on 1 second. Hold on, y'all. Father God, we come before you right now, Lord God. I just, as I touch my brother Dante, Lord God, that you will continue to use him for your glory, Lord God, and that job, Lord God, will not be able to come in and divide and conquer, Lord God, what you have placed in front of him, Lord God, because you have called him the Bible man, Lord God, and that he's given out Bibles to, Lord God, those in the streets, Lord God. He's given out Bibles to those, Lord God, that has a celebrity status, Lord God. But we know, Lord God, that you are the only celebrity. You are the only one that's famous, Lord God. We are ponds, Lord God, living in your water, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you have called us, Lord God, to do these exploits, Lord God, in this earth, Lord God, but we ought to be mindful, Lord God, it is you that called us to him. And we thank you, Lord God, as he continues to give these Bibles out. Yes, he's getting attacked, but Lord God, we thank you that you are the attack solver. We thank you, Lord God, that no weapon that is formed against him or his job shall prosper. We thank you, Lord God, that his spirit is being built up right now, Lord God, as I speak. Lord God, thank you, Lord God. You said you hear those that speak your word back to him. Lord God, we speak your word back. I speak your word back. Lord God, I thank you, Lord God, right now, that no weapon that is formed against his job shall prosper. And the young man that came in, Lord God, that tries to do what he do, Lord God, because he's well connected, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that still favor, Lord God, because when you called yours to do a great job, Lord God, no weapon formed, and we should slide and slip in any doors, Lord God. Lord God, I thank you right now, Father God, that the door is still open, Lord God, and he will not be let go from that job. We thank you, Lord God, that his job, Lord God, his assignment, Lord God, is to continue to do what you have called him to do, and it will be so. And I just thank you right now, Father, that no one can come and close the door that you have opened. And I thank you, Lord God. He's been a faithful servant, Lord God, and giving out them Bibles, Lord God. He's been spending half of his check, Lord God, giving out Bibles, Lord God. He don't have to do it, Lord God. We just thank you right now that you will see fit, Lord God, that the doors will stay open, Lord God, as long as he stay obedient. And we know he will stay obedient. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
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 Hey, Derek, this is Chavez again. How are you?
Hey, Chavez.
Did you pray for my girlfriend? She's been, you know, trying to find a job. I've been trying to pray for her, to say she's going to find one.
Okay. Yeah, she's looking still right now, huh?
She's looking still right now. You know, she didn't grow up for nobody to hand her nothing. She cut it before her dad passed. Told her to be independent, never depend on nobody.
Right.
Kind of hard because I'm the one who's basically, you know, trying to provide for keep this house going. It's a lot of frustration on me.
Right. It's a lot of frustrations too. I'll talk to you about the other stuff later, but like I said earlier, you know why a lot is going on. But I just pray now that the God will, that our God, your God, her God, all of our gods that's listening on the sound of our voice, will restore her to a place where she knows she needs to be. We know that she's not lazy. We know that she'll work a job. And we know that she's been looking. And we know that she haven't found anything. And it's the reason why. And that reason why, you and her may know the reason. But I pray that God will place the reason in your spirit. And you guys can come to a resolve. And know that the resolve will bring increase. If the resolve is not set, if the resolve is not looked upon as important, the increase won't be. But as you continue to do as I said earlier, and as she comes to that place of resolve, where is she at right now?
Right here by me right now.
Put her on the phone. Hey, how are you?
Good.
Good. So you've been looking, right?
Yes.
But nothing has clicked. What about, and I'm sure, you know what? Even places that you thought that would hire you right off the bat didn't hire you, right?
Yes.
You know the reason why, right?
No.
I don't want to say it over the phone, but Chavez will tell you. And it's not saying that it seems to be unfair at times, but it's not, because when you got a call in your life, if you're not doing everything right, you're going to get attacked by everything around you. And what the enemy attack? The enemy attack your body, your money, your mind, and your spirit. And not saying that because you're obedient that things will work itself out, because we just in a world where it's just full of sin and things will just happen. You know, we hear that, we read that, you know, be of good cheer. But it's some things that needs to be in order. And God is a God of order, and we want order in our lives, but he's looking for order from us as well. But I'm going to pray. Father, I just come before you right now, Lord, and I just ask that you will touch your dear child with a job. She needs a job. She needs work. She needs her own money, Father. But the job that you have for her, the greater job, Lord God, as she falls in line through obedience, Lord God, that job will be waiting for her. But right now, Lord God, get her something, Lord God, right now that she can have some money coming in her pocket, Father. We know that you are the way maker. We know that you can open up doors, Lord God. And I just touch and agree right now with her and Chavez that a door will be open for a job. And Lord God, the second job, Lord God, as she continues to seek you out, Lord God, she will know what it is that she needs to do to get that second job. And that second job is right around the corner after the first one. But it's going to be through your obedience. And as you stay obedient, God is going to continue to show you things, because you had a life that you question God and wonder why you and why this and why that. But God has called you out for such a time as this. And you was called out. Your parents, both your mother and father's gone, right?
Yes.
So it's you and who, your sister?
My three sisters and one brother.
Okay. And you, are you the youngest? Father, I thank you right now, Lord God, that the youngest, Lord God, where she feels that she's the youngest, Lord God, and she don't have anything, Lord God. I just thank you now, Lord God, that she will even come to a place in her life, Lord God, that she will mature, Lord God, not only in her mind, but in her career. I ask, Lord God, you will give her a career, not just a job, that she will be able to look back at this day and know that it was you that blessed her, Lord God. She will be able to look back at her siblings. Her siblings will be able to look at her and say, wow, how did you get that? How did you grow so fast? But because of you, Lord God, through her obedience and her submission to you. And it is so, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Irwin, what's up, brother? Another Navy buddy of mine. Jeez. Man, I haven't seen you guys since 1994. Wow. I don't know if anyone, there's so many to look through. Yes, we pray for the Bates family. Keep them lifted up as they go on through their grieving right now. Lord God, I just come before you for Valerie Duncan Kelly, Lord God. I just ask in the name of Jesus that you will just set her free, make her free, Lord God, from the bondage, Lord God, that's trying to surround her and take her down, take her under. We thank you, Lord God, that bondage, Lord God, is not of you, Lord God. You have released us. You have moved us out of Exodus, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that Exodus was just a mindset, not just a place. I thank you now, Lord God, that Valerie's mindset would change after tonight, that she would know that you are a healer. She would know that you are a deliverer. She would know that you have made her free. I thank you, Lord God. Setting someone free, Lord God, gives the enemy an opportunity to bring them back. But when you are made free, you are free indeed. I thank you for the making her free right now. I thank you right now that Valerie will have a fresh new start as of tomorrow. Tomorrow, her mind will begin to think, Lord God, and will begin to see differently, Lord God. Things will not bother her as they did today. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord God, right now that things, Lord God, will be in a different place in her mind, will be in a different place in her heart. You have created a space somewhere to throw those things, Lord God, where she can just think about those later and pray on them now. I thank you, Lord God, that you will have her to look at those things, Lord God, and see that it wasn't all of that after all. I thank you right now, Father, that she will be able to know exactly what to do in the situation that she's dealing with right now, that you will bring light as you have already shined light tonight, but tomorrow the light will be brighter. I thank you right now, Lord God, that it is so, and you will do it speedily. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen.
Valerie, I'm not sure. I don't think I know you, Valerie. That's right, Adrian. Tearing down everything. Yeah, Kim, I feel like my grandmother sometimes. Yeah. Perfect love casts out all fear. So much. Father God, we come before you right now for Joanne, Lord God. I've been knowing Joanne 35 years. Father, I just ask, Lord God, that you will give her a heart, Lord God, of peace, Lord God. That you will turn that heavy heart to, Lord God, a heart of feathers, Lord God. Father God, you said you would change a stony heart, Lord God. You would sprinkle clean water on it, Lord God, in your word. So, Lord God, sprinkle, Lord God, a fresh, Lord God, on her. Sprinkle your anointing on her heart, Lord God. Lord God, make her free, Lord God. Show her things, Lord God, in a different light, Lord God. Allow her, Lord God, to see, Lord God, that it's you, Lord God, that it's all things, Lord God. Seeking you out, Father, as we touch and agree, Lord God, together, Lord God, that things will begin to spring forth right now, Lord God. In her heart, Lord God, and she would begin to feel lighter, Lord God. She would have a resolve as well, Lord God, with the way, Lord God, things have been going on in her life. I thank you, Lord God, for restorations, Lord God, in her soul, Lord God, within herself, Lord God, with the relationship, Father. I thank you, Lord God, that the relationship with you, Lord God, is well needed, Lord God, and everything else will work itself out. I thank you, Lord God, that she commits herself, Lord God, to have a relationship with you, Lord God. Everything else, Lord God, will be identified, Lord God, as nothing. I thank you now, Lord God, that the heaviness of the heart, Lord God, is the absence of you being in her heart. I thank you, Lord God, as she goes in even more with you, Lord God, as she seeks you out more, as she picks up that word more, as she reaches out to hear more about you, Lord God, that she will begin to smile even more, Lord God. That smile will be a smile of joy, Lord God, a smile of restoration, a smile of happiness. I thank you now, Lord, that you're doing it right now, Lord God, as I speak. Lord God, that it is done as I speak. I just seen the white, bright light, Joanne. A bright light. And God is shining on you. Because you submitted yourself to reach out and ask for help, ask for prayer. And because you have done that, the light has shined on you. And your heart will begin to feel lighter, if not right now. You will begin to feel the presence of God. Because God has never left you, because you always had God in your heart. But he just wants more of you right now in this hour. And again, the light is shining on you. This is the time to take advantage. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen.
Father, I pray for Linda again today, Lord God. I pray and just lift her up, Lord God, with her family, Lord God, that the family, Lord God, will be restored, Lord God. And as she continues to submit to you, Lord, you will show her how to respond, how to react, Lord God, how to fight, Lord God, in the spirit. Not just with the mouth, not just with the words, Lord God, not with the feeling, but in the spirit. I thank you, Lord. Jesus' name, I pray, amen.
Amen.
Oh. All right. Anyone have a quick testimony? Something real quick. Okay. I just seen something pop up, Valerie. I don't know what that was. Oh, God bless you, Laurie. Thank God Adrian shared it. This is even a blessing for me as well, even though I be drained at times. We've been doing this for 2 years now. Haven't missed a week. 2 years plus.
Plus 2 months.
You're welcome, Valerie. That's it. And just keep claiming it. Keep claiming it no matter what comes your way, because the enemy will come back. He will. He loved for you to feel good for the moment. And after that moment, the next day or the next week or the next month, he'll come back again. That's when you have to remind him who you are and who he is. He's a defeated foe. He has no leg to stand on. He was a spirit. Jesus Christ was the only one who came as a man. He was divine. But the enemy has no spirit. He has no right. He has no birth certificate. He was not a being. So he tries to jump into beings to make his way. But as we continue to fill ourselves with knowledge and understanding of God, we will know that he's already a defeated foe. He's a puppet inside the jack-in-the-box that pops up. So naturally, any being that turns to the right or to the left behind him and sees something pop up, they're going to be afraid. But just know that he's a defeated foe. He has no right, legal right, to even be here. Jesus Christ is the only being, only spiritual being that has a right to be here. He was human and divine. He was man yet divine, and man yet spirit, man yet God. Yes, Lord. Joanne, is it a, No, I'll talk to you later about it, Joanne. I'm not going to bring it up. But anyone else? Okay. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for Kim, Lord God. Kim has been, Lord God, there from the very beginning. She knew about my situation even before I knew her. My grandmother used to tell her about how terrible I was and how I was selling drugs and how I needed to be saved and how she stayed on the wall for me and how she had the church praying for me, and Kim was praying for me before I even knew Kim. So I thank Kim that God was obedient to continue to pray for me. I thank Myra, my aunt, for even praying for me because she knew how wicked and crazy I was. I didn't want to hear anything about God. Now I can't get enough of God. I pray for Kim's strength in the Lord, for her to stay on that wall, for her to be the gatekeeper, for her to be the mother to the family. She has no children of her own, but she has children that's placed in this earth that God has placed her under. I thank you, Lord God, right now that you will keep her mounted up, Lord God, with wings as eagles. I thank you, Lord God, you will keep Myra mounted up as wings as eagles. Those, even Roxanna, know how I was and how God has changed me. That's why I know it's a God. I know he can change anybody if I was changed. I wanted to get hold of Ouija boards. I wanted to run with Satan. I didn't want nothing to do with God. Satan could have had me, but it was a purpose for my life, and God seemed fit that it be fulfilled through my submission. When I submitted to God, God opened up doors that not even I could believe. So through your submission, God will show you who you are. Because you don't know who you are until you submit. And if you don't submit, you're in a state of rebellion. The state of rebellion is a state of witchcraft. It's going against what you know you're supposed to do for God. But yeah, I shot at cops. I sold drugs. I flipped over in four different vehicles. Doing 60, 70 miles an hour on one vehicle on the expressway. Smack dead behind the car, still walked out. Flipped over three times on the expressway, still walked out. I shot at twice, close range, bullets missed. So I know it's a God. My high school in Chicago, they used to carry guns. At that time, I didn't believe in God. I just made a statement, as every child stated, if I make it through high school, it has to be a God, because our high school was wild back then, 1981, 83. But just stay on the wall. That's right, he comes to steal. Steal our mind. No more shackles, no more pain. You know what? I think we need to hear that before I close out. No more chains. I'm free. Who is that? Tasha Cobbs, right? Okay, no more chains. No more chains. Glory to Jesus. Okay, where you at? Break every chain. Come on, Tasha. Glory to Jesus. I thank everyone for being on here tonight, and it's been a long night. But God place it on me to just pray tonight. No scriptures or anything, just pray. And I'm going to pray and play this out. If you would like to drop, go ahead and drop. If not, let's continue. How many know that there's power in that name? You can't go in China freely and speak about the name of Jesus or you will be locked up. There's certain places they don't want to hear that name. Why? Because there's power behind that name. Demons tremble. So guess what? If the people will tremble, if the people don't want to hear that name, it's a demon inside of them. We fight not against... Come on. We don't fight against the man, the woman. We fight against that demon in them. That name has power. If you go say Allah, they're not going to mess with you. You go give them your name, they're not going to respond to you. You guys go say Malcolm X, Willie Lynch. They're going to just look at you crazy. But if you say Jesus, you might get killed. You might get locked up. You may lose a friend. We know his name. The Greek name is Yahshua. But we know him as Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Break every chain. The chains is falling. The chains are falling. Hey, glory to Jesus. Raise them up, raise them up, raise them up. Raise them up. Here you go. Break chains. That's right, Kenny. We're here to encourage each other. We're here to lift each other up. No one is greater than the next. We all joint heirs with Christ. One body, one mind. Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah. We command every chain to be broken. Every demon in hell, every imp on assignment. You have lost ground. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Every chain is broken. Power. Yes, Lord. Glory to Jesus. Yes, Lord. Jesus. Oh yes, that's the cross. The cross. Carry your cross. Carry your cross. Lay every weight at the cross. And know that Jesus is your Redeemer. That's right. How would you react if you know the chain breaker is here? Well, guess what? He's here right now. He's been on this call the whole time. As I prayed and broke ground for those first 40 minutes, went in for 40 minutes and everyone came in. Everyone came in strong. We bombarded heaven tonight. Heaven has heard from us tonight. Heaven has heard from us tonight. Believe me, Heaven has heard from us tonight. I just speak prosperity in your life, over your life, over your family. I thank you now, Lord God, that you will continue to press on us so that we can know and believe and trust and rely and adhere to you so that others can come after you because of us. I thank you, Lord God, right now that we are the light, Lord God, in the dark place. We are the lily in the valley, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, we will stay free, Lord God. We will stay free from the enemy's plans, for the enemy's scheme. We will not be caught up in his lies, Lord God. You said you will allow us to be, you will not allow us to be ignorant of Satan's devices. I thank you right now, Lord God, that you allowed us to see, Lord God, in the spirit. You allowed us to hear in the spirit. You have opened our spirit, Lord God, up, Lord God, to a different place, Lord God, right now. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord God, that you have placed us, Lord God, into your bosom. Yes, Lord God. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Glory to Jesus. The chains are broken. They're broken tonight. Receive your healing. Speak over your life. Nothing negative. Speak it. Break every chain. Every chain has been broken. Speak it. Every chain has been broken. Speak it. Well, we can't get enough of you. We need you in this season. Again, January is very, very critical. There's a lot going on in January. This is going to model the rest of the year. January is going to model the rest of the year. So my advice is to stay in God's face. Stay in his face. Every week we've been on this call, 2 years and 2 months without missing. We're standing in his face. Yes, we may slip, we may fall, things may happen. Some people may not join. That's okay. You don't have to join this call. Join somebody's call. It's not about me. It's about him. It's about Jesus. I was told I'm supposed to ask for offerings. I don't care about offerings. I care about getting people to Jesus.
The next time you have to face a situation, glory to God, you don't know how you're going to handle it, you ought to look it in the face and say, there is power.
Power in that name of Jesus. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that he is God. Lord God, I just ask that you would just touch and bless and heal and speak to everyone within my proximity. God was showing me a dream the other day about proximity. Those that's attacking you are those that's in your home. Those are the foes. Those are like close to you in your proximity. But God says to bless them anyhow. That's the only way you're going to be blessed immensely. You got to bless them. He's allowing them to test you, to try you. But you have to bless them anyhow. You have to bless them anyhow. You have to bless those that persecute you. Do good to those that talk about you. Galatians 6:1. If any sin of any sort, you that are spiritual, lift them up without any superiority and take a look at yourself. Keep an attentive eye on yourself. We all fail. We all will fall. But guess what? Iron sharpens iron. We're here to lift each other up, not dog each other out. We're here to pick each other up, restore them, not talk about them. The chains will continue to fall. Glory to Jesus. I just seen a man now with a light going on over the head. And I can only think of it has to be Jesus. So Jesus is definitely here tonight. I seen a man's shoulders in a white, all white. The face was white. And a shiny light was white, shining down on him. Go in with God now. I thought I was getting off the call a few minutes ago, but no, I got to stay on here a little longer. Lord, we need you. Lord, we bless your holy name. Horoboshi. Lord, we need you right now. We need your presence to be with us. We need restoration. We need you to restore us. We repent now, Lord God, for everything we may have done or said to anyone else, Lord God. We repent now. We repent now, Lord God. You must release it out of your mouth. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for the download. We thank you, Lord God. Speak it. Open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. The Holy One is here. January, this is the month we must go in. This is the month. It's going to model the rest of the year and the rest of your life. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Boraba leke shiki. Horobua baba kashiki. Yes, Lord God. We thank you now. We thank you. We thank you. We need you, Lord God. Yes, Lord God. Cleanse us. Restore us, Lord God, while there's snow. We complain about the snow, but we need the snow because the snow is a representation. It symbolizes purity. It freezes everything as of old. It kills it off. We thank you for the snow. We thank you for the rain, Lord God. We need your press. We need you to press. And we need your press. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, that pressing, Lord God, in this season, Lord God, is going to bring out the best in us. See, Oroshaka. The Lord said, taste and see. Oh, the windows of heaven is open.
Send down your blessings, Lord.
Send them down, Lord, as we worship you.
I just need you to move in this place tonight.
He's doing it right now. Lord, we thank you. We thank you that you open yourself up to us, Lord God. Lord God, we not only are touching your hands, Lord God, but we're touching your emotion. Oh, rain on us, Lord.
Open.
Oh, yeah, God.
Thank you, Father.
Let it rain.
Yes,
Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Let it rain. Help me, somebody,
yes,
say it tonight.
The Lord says to stay right there. Stay right there. Yes, Lord. We're here, Lord God. We're here, Lord God. We're ready to receive whatever it is that you have for us. We're not here to ask for anything, Lord God. We're here, Lord God, to receive whatever it is that you have. We know in your presence there's blessings, Lord God. In your presence there's restoration, Lord God. In your presence, Lord God, you will be able to speak to our mind, our body, and our soul. Lord God, there's correction in your presence, Lord God. We ask, Lord God, that you will continue to just pour yourself into us. We thank you, Lord. Oh, yeah, God. Yes, Lord God. Let it rain, Lord. Let it rain. Let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. Rain on us. Rain on us. Yes, Lord God. Pour palekishi. Chukurababakasha. There's going to be a shift in politicians. Shelarekurabakache e dalara tuku. There's going to be an upset. Corrale, corra, babacache, e do boroba. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you that every strong hurt, every stronghold, Lord God, has been broken, has been brought down. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, that we're in your presence. We thank you, Father. Oh, glory to your name, Jesus. We thank you. Glory to your name, Jesus. We thank you. I don't know who's on this call that's supposed to be going overseas. But when you go overseas, the Lord says you are protected. You are not to fear. It's okay to say Jesus. We know in times past that it was martyred by saying Jesus, but now he's going to protect you that go. He said, glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to your name.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Release, release, release. As you release, I bind up the spirit of fear in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Have your way tonight, Lord God. Have your way tonight, Lord God. Go in. I thank you, Lord God, for allowing us to reach heaven. I thank you, Lord God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Glory to Jesus. Who feels better tonight? Who feels free? Who feels light? I was sleepy. I was falling asleep before the call. Now I'm wide awake. I'm wide awake. How many know that the Spirit of God will give you that energy that you need? But we must rest in him. We must seek him first before any and everything. In the morning, don't look at Facebook. Don't look at Instagram. Don't look at Black Planet. Don't look at Plenty of Fish looking for a man or a woman. Look for God, and God is going to make the way perfect for you. Every crooked thing that's been bent out of shape, it's a way for you, and he is the way maker. Stop it. Stop looking for other resources. He is the source. He is the source. That's the reason why things haven't been lined up. Because you forget about it when things are great. Can he trust you in $1 million? Will you still go after and seek God weekly? Will you still seek God daily? Will you still seek God every hour on the hour? Some seek God because they're hurting. But what would happen if he opened the doors? That's the reason why some haven't got it. That's the reason why we're still in this place where we're wanting, where we're asking, where we're seeking, and it hasn't opened up. Yeah, we say his delay is not his denial. We say that the timing is not right. But the timing can be our own fault. It can be our fault. So when are we going to come to a place where we can say, God, it is my fault that I don't have what I want. It is my fault.
It is my fault.
But through God, through our faithfulness, through our obedience, all these things will be restored. Tonight, the water has been troubled. Tonight, people have been set and made free. And tonight, heavy shoulders have become light. Glory. Amen, Mercedes. Yeah, just fall asleep driving and prayed, worship, and woke up. That's right. Lord God, give Valerie understanding and direction. He is the GPS, Valerie. He is the GPS. He is the one that will give you that direction and understanding and guidance. He will. And it started tonight. And you're going to have a testimony too. Posture of hearts. And the words of the mouth has to line up. That's right, Kim. When our backs was against the wall, he made a way for you. So don't forget him when them doors begin to open by March 8th. Don't forget him when your back was against the wall. Know that he made the way. I'm just a willing vessel to spend my time speaking to myself and to his people. But he made the way. Not one man, not one woman out here can do it without him. Not one. Because not one is righteous. We're all filthy rags. Anyone can get up here. God can replace me tonight. But I'm submitted to do this purposely, on purpose. Yeah, we've been on here, what, 2 hours and 17 minutes? That's okay. Me personally, I wanted to be an hour and get off this phone to continue straightening up this new place. But I always allow God to have his way with me. But I won't worry about anything else. Because in God is the way. He's omnipotent. All knowing. All powerful. Yes. Well, how many was blessed? Anyone want to give a testimony before I hang up? Okay, Dante had one.
It was about these two little kids. This is for you, housewarming gift.
Oh, wow. Dante gave me a housewarming gift. Guess what it is? The original King James Bible, the 1611. Kim, don't kill him. Oh my God. This is the original Bible, y'all.
Wow, man. Amen.
This is the original Bible, the King James Bible that everyone's trying to get a hold of. The 1611. The 400th anniversary edition, Jesus.
Amen, hallelujah.
Wow.
And that was, you know, that's good, because I didn't want to give it up. I love him that much, for my brother.
Oh, man, thank you, brother.
I love him that much,
man. Oh, my God.
Didn't want to kill him, so I had to. Housewoman and a birthday gift from one.
Oh my goodness. Kim said, Dante, where's my Bible? Oh my God, this is it. Everyone been trying to find it.
So
we get back to the testimony.
So
it's about
the King James Bible. So two little kids. They had to be like, one was 5 and the other one was about 10. So I go to this church called Christian Love, and they have a Wednesday Bible study. So I'm gonna make it short and simple. I bought 2 King James Bibles, and I went to the church today Bible study, and I left the King James Bibles inside the supermarket. It was in ShopRite because they sell Bibles in ShopRite, the one I go to. So the 2 kids, I promised them I was going to get them Bibles. Had to rush all the way back to the supermarket where I left it. I never leave Bibles, of all things. Went back, got it, gave it to the 2 little kids. And then my aunt says to me, you know, when you gave those Bibles, those 2 little kids, they in the front sitting in the church and they praising God. And she's like, you know, next time when you go to give Bibles out, can you give like these little kids Bibles out?
Mm.
I said, why would I did that? I gave those 2 little kids the King James Bibles. And look, see how funny, how you telling me to do something and God's telling me to do that.
So that's why.
So I'm just telling people, Jesus, it doesn't matter how old they are, God touched everybody's heart.
The babies. The babies.
And they loved it more than the adults.
The babies.
So that's how powerful his word is. It's sharper than a 2-edged sword.
Cutting the asunder of the soul and the spirit. That's it. Wow.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Kim said that testimony saved your head. She away from hers. Valerie, okay, Val. So, you got a great understanding.
Oh, what she said about that.
Yeah. We all in pursuit of still understanding who God is and what God does and how God does it. No one actually ever knows the fullness of God. We get a taste of him. But as long as we're in pursuit. But I wouldn't want to close out without asking someone else if they have a testimony or do you want to say something. One thing about me, I'm not selfish, even though I want to get off. But I don't think that I can right now until everyone gets out what they want to get out. So if someone wants to say something, the floor is yours. If you want to call in, the number is 641-715-3580. 641-715-3580. The access code is 805-700-POUND. And if it won't allow you to get in, just keep trying. It's the end of it. So I'll wait, and I'll play one more song while we see if someone's going to call in. There was someone supposed to call in last week, and God told me it was someone else, and they need to call in because it was a blessing for them. But we find out that they was afraid to call in. So don't allow Satan to steal what God has for you. I'll wait for about a good portion of this song before I end the call. Wow, got my Bible.
Look, I'm trying to give you this one, but I...
Oh, man. Look what he's trying to give me, y'all. But God touched his heart. One thing I can say about Dante, he has been obedient since I've known him. Look at the difference. Oh, man. God bless you, Dante. Oh, my God, yo. Jesus.
Oh,
I was like, Jesus, you know what, God. Yeah, what's up, my way? You and Kim gonna kill me. I can't find it. That was the only one, right?
This is the only one. He been looking for this thing.
No, Wayne, that's the only one, right? Wayne, I'm a Bible man, so that was in my crib. I literally, like, you know what?
He went everywhere looking for that 1611.
Because, what happened? Yeah, tell him the testimony about that.
We watched a program one night, and it was a man talking about the different versions of the Bible. And the King James Version, the 1611, was the original one. And they did a spinoff off of that one and created the NIV. They created the Standard. They created all the other Bibles from this one. And some of them negate the fact that Jesus is Lord. And you know what? I should have had all them prepared. Well, I wasn't thinking about it, though. It just came up.
Remember, that goes back to that testimony with that guy who was on the street when we just listened to him for 20 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
That's a crazy testimony. He was like, no, Jehovah.
Right. And what happened was, it was a guy on the street that was basically confused but not confused about who Jesus was because of different versions of the Bible. Now, if you look at the NIV and look at the King James Version of Isaiah 14, where it talks about how thou art fallen, O Lucifer. The morning star, let me find it. I'll get it later because it's going to mess up the song. But, matter of fact, next week or later on during the week, I may give you all the examples of the scriptures. And the scriptures, basically, it will have you confused on that's some of the versions. And that's the intent.
And the history about that, the guy that actually rewritten it, he died the next day he rewritten.
Oh, wow. The guy died the next day after he rewritten the Bible? Which Bible? Which version? The NIV. Wow. Okay, so no one wants to call in? Okay, that's cool. We worship, we praised, we touched heaven. I'll go ahead and end this call from here. Thank you all, love you all. May God keep you throughout this week. And by next Thursday, 8 o'clock Eastern Standard, 7 o'clock Central. Which 7 o'clock is my hometown, Chicago. But as I dismiss this call, but never the presence of God, that we will be and stay continued free. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.